A 2-Hour Koran, written by Bill Warner, narrated by Bill Warner.
This book is dedicated to the millions of victims of jihad over the past 1400 years. May you hear this and become a voice for the voiceless.
To the reader. After the attack on the World Trade Towers on September 11, 2001, I realized that I lived in a world where almost no one knew the doctrine of Islam. My study of Islam started over 40 years ago, so I decided that I would devote my life to educating the world about political Islam. Once you understand the doctrine, you will understand history and what is to come. Few people understand Islam because its doctrine is based upon the trilogy of texts, the Quran, the Sirah, the biography of Mohammed, and Hadith, his traditions, which are all written in an obscure manner. This book gives the reader a simple way to understand Islamic doctrine. The method used in this book for understanding Islamic doctrine is, you study Islamic political doctrine, not religion or Muslims. The writing is straightforward and simple. Learning takes place in stages and through repetition. This book is from the perspective of the non-Muslim, so the religion is of no importance. This book contains objective knowledge, not opinions. All references can be read and verified by using the reference number that precedes paragraphs. This book is based on fact-based reasoning. A common dismissal of Islamic doctrine is that moderate Muslims do not follow it. This book is not about Muslims, moderate or extreme, but about Islamic political doctrine and history. You will only get a personal point of view when you ask a Muslim about Islam. And what kind of Muslim do you ask, moderate or jihadi? Both moderate Muslims and jihadis all submit to the Sunnah of Muhammad and the Quran. We are fortunate to live in a time when the doctrine of Islam has been made simple. Islam is a fascinating subject. Enjoy your read. Bill Warner, PhD. Preface. The CSPI Doctrinal Teaching Method. Everything you say about political Islam has to reference the Islamic foundational text found in the trilogy, Quran, Sirah, Hadith. The CSPI teaching method is the easiest and quickest way to learn about Islam. Authoritative. There are only two ultimate authorities about Islam, Allah and Muhammad. Allah is found in the Quran. Muhammad is found in the Sirah, Muhammad's biography, and in the Hadith, his words and actions. CSPI approaches these three Islamic texts from the point of view of the kafir, non-Muslim. A referencing system allows the reader to verify the book content from the Islamic foundational source text. Systemic knowledge. The easiest way to study Islam is to see the whole picture. For instance, the Quran alone cannot be understood due to a lack of context, but when the life of Muhammad is added, it makes sense. Levels of learning. The ideas of Islam are very foreign to our civilization. It takes repetition to grasp the new ideas. The CSPI method uses four levels of training to teach the doctrine in depth. The first level is designed for a beginner and lays out the entire scope of Islam. Each level and book repeats the basics to ensure in-depth learning. Therefore, each book can be read on its own or as part of a full series. Political Islam, not religious Islam. Islam has a political doctrine and a religious doctrine. Its political doctrine concerns everyone, while the religious Islam only concerns Muslims. CSPI books deal only with political Islam and Muhammad, not Muslims. Scientific approach. The CSPI method employs a rational or scientific approach with fact-based reasoning to deconstruct the Islamic doctrine. CSPI uses simple statistics, graphs, and categorization to analyze the doctrine. We do not question the truth of the doctrine, we merely examine objectively what there is. We hold this truth to be self-evident. Quran plus Sirah plus Hadith, the trilogy, is equal to Islamic doctrine. To uphold the truth of the doctrine, CSPI stresses the importance of precise naming when discussing political Islam. Introduction, Chapter 1. Up until now, the study of Islamic doctrine has been by Arab language scholars, historians, theologians, and students of Middle East culture. Critical thought has been used, but there's never been a completely fully scientific approach to Islamic doctrine. There are two things you've been told about Islam that are not true. The first is that it's only a religion. This is the most common misconception. Generally speaking, those who maintain that Islam is just a religion are non-Muslims, because most Muslims insist on the fact that Islam is a complete philosophy, a complete way of life that includes religion, but also politics, culture, and everything else it takes to run a civilization. The second error is that Islam is nearly impossible to understand, or at least that it takes a great deal of lengthy study in school, preferably college. The scientific method. The CSPI books utilize a scientific approach in order to get results that go beyond opinion. Because if we're going to speak about Islam, we need to have more than opinion. We have enough of that already. We need a fact-based approach, something that makes sense and is coherent. We also need an explanation that is systematic and shows us the entire story of Islam in a straightforward manner. If we try to sort out the different opinions about Islam, and we look to a professional or an expert, exactly which expert do we turn to? If we're going to ask a Muslim, do we ask someone who is nice, or do we ask a jihadist? Because both of them claim to be Muslims. Do we ask a college professor, someone in the media, a Muslim at work, or do we go to the internet? Because when we go to the internet, there's a riot of opinions on Islam. But how do you sort it out? Where do we find factual information? The study of Islam is also obscured by political correctness. Criticism of Islam is frequently called bigotry because anything that is said that offends Muslim is considered racism or bigotry. This political correctness shuts off any real debate because if someone says something that a Muslim finds offensive, then how are we ever to discuss anything that is negative about Islam? There are negative aspects of all thought systems and all philosophies. We have to be able to move beyond the fact that critical thought is called bigoted thought. What is the true nature of Islam? We cannot find out the true nature of Islam by media comments or other informal methods. To do this, we will have to find a way to discuss Islam that is fact-based, scientific, and provable, one that goes beyond opinion. If something is objective or scientific, it means that no matter who does the work, they will come up with the same results. We must have an objective way to study Islam in which everyone gets the same answer. Using a scientific approach is going to let us be absolutely authoritative. We're going to be able to state things about Islam, and we're going to know that we're right, that this is not just an opinion, but that it has substance and facts behind it. Part of the scientific method is precisely defined terms and names. What we see today are words that are vague and subjective. What is an extremist Muslim? The name extremist Muslim is not found anywhere in Islamic doctrine. The CSPI method uses names and terms that are based upon the doctrine. The starting point. If we're going to have a scientific analysis of Islam, we have to have a foundation that is unassailable. Because if we start off from a questionable assumption, then everything after that can be challenged. There's a place for the study of Islam that is absolutely sure and certain. That's the point at which we can start, that every Muslim from the past, the present, and the future all agree without a single exception. That is the statement. There is no God but Allah, and Muhammad is his messenger. This declaration of Muhammad and Allah is called the Shahada, and if said in Arabic in front of witnesses, means that you are now a practicing Muslim. But this statement about Muhammad and Allah is not just the beginning of Islam, but also the very foundation and even the totality of Islam. How can such a small statement contain all of Islam? It talks about Muhammad and about Allah. And it turns out that all of Islam, without any exception, is based upon Allah and Muhammad. There is no God but Allah. Now, where will we learn about Allah? Well, that would come from the Quran, which seems a difficult place to start because the Quran seems to be so little understood. But as we will see, the Quran can quite easily be understood and we can understand the true nature of Allah after we know who Muhammad is. The two Qurans. Let's examine the Quran. Frequently, it is a big, thick, green book that contains both English and Arabic. When we try to read it, it's quite puzzling. First off, there doesn't seem to be any time in the Quran. When we turn a page, we don't go forward in time, we could go backwards in time, or perhaps we're not even sure if time has moved at all. It also seems chaotic. One subject follows another in a seemingly random fashion. Then we come to contradictions. We'll read one verse in the Quran which seems kind. Quran 109:6. You have your religion, and I have my religion. But there are other passages in the Quran which are very violent, cutting off hands and feet, crucifixions and torture. Quran 9:5. When the sacred months are over, slay the idolaters wherever you find them, arrest them, besiege them, lie in ambush everywhere for them. If they repent and take to prayer and render the alms levy, then allow them to go their way. God is forgiving and merciful. Thank you.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.